This is instrumentation, lecture 5. We are looking at still in the signal conditioning topics. Now we are looking basically at the amplifiers, the op amps. As you may have seen from the previous lectures, we have some introduction to op-amps. All right, how we use basically op-amps to form up inverting and also non-inverting amplifiers. We have seen how we basically derive the gain formulation and how we construct the circuit, the input resistors, the feedback resistors into making a simple op-amp to become an amplifier. All right, so we have seen inverting and non-inverting type. For this particular chapter, for this particular lecture, we are going to see how we use those op-amps on chips into making up another circuit that basically do and perform extended function or some specific function. All right. Okay, this is again about the op-amp. So the first circuit that we are going to see, basically known as voltage follower. As for the voltage follower, this is basically the circuit and the schematic of voltage follower. This is only one a single unit of op-amp being used. And your input is basically directly connected to the positive leg of the op-amp chip, right? And your V-in is connected to this one, and this is just the ground or the reference pin. And the negative side of the op-amp pin is connected directly to the output. All right. So in this particular circuit, you will see there is no gain. Factor has been set because there is no input resistor and there is no feedback resistor. As you may recall, the gain is basically coming into the calculation where you have to include the value of feedback resistors and input resistors. This is where you get the gain factor for both inverting and non-inverting. Feedback resistor and input resistor is in the calculation, but as you can see from this slide, you don't have any resistors, not at the input and not at the feedback. So basically, there is no gain consideration for this circuit. Basically, you know, if you give 5 volts in the input, you will get 5 volt in the output. All right, as I mentioned, there is no gain. Or you can consider it as gain equal to 1. So whatever you give in the input, you will get back in the output. So there is no amplification, there is no attenuation. All right. This particular circuit is basically just used for impedance matching. All right. As they say here, to adjust impedance between transducer input, transducer output, and the voltage recording instrument of this voltage follower circuit. So this circuit also known as unity gain buffer amplifier. So input and output for this voltage follower circuit is the same, just that impedance in the input and impedance in the output is basically different. So we just use this for some kind of impedance matching activity. All right. So again, I repeat, there is no change in the voltage input and output for this particular circuit. Whatever you give in the input, you will get it in the output. There is no amplification, there is no attenuation. You just need the circuit to do the impedance matching. For example, if you have a sensor, if you have a temperature sensor, which output impedance of the sensor is around 5 ohm, for example, but you need to connect the sensor to some other circuits, which having like 5 mega ohm kind of impedance. So the 5 ohm impedance temperature signal, you cannot straight away connect to 5 mega ohm device. So you need to change the impedance. You need to raise up the impedance. So in the middle, you need voltage follower circuit, which will be the matching for you, because you have to do some kind of configuration. Okay, that's the use of voltage follower circuit. And then you have also op-amp being used in a different configuration to form up a summing amplifier. As you can see, in this case, we have voltage V1 and voltage V2 in the input. Each of this input line is connected through a resistor. Okay, in this case, it's R1. Okay, connected to the a junction where you have feedback resistor is coming here to RF. And then the input going to the negative side, negative pin of the op-amp. So this is some kind of inverting amplifier. Okay. So what important here is that you have both of your what they call that input are connected to the same point, which connects to the feedback resistor as well as the negative side of the pin. So just in case if you have one input, you can basically arrange the input in this manner, and you have to connect to the same point. This is, for example, V3. Okay, for example, if you have the fourth input, you can do the same, but you have to still connect to the same point. This is V4, for example. Okay, if you have more, you can always do it, but the most important thing you have to remember if you have is you have to connect all of those things to one point without having any other devices in between. And you have to connect all those things like short to the same point. This is how you basically use it. Okay. And then here they say signals from two or more sources must be added to obtain the output signal. Okay, so in this case, you are seeing of the whole amplifier on the V outside, okay, is equal to negative RF, okay, in the bracket VR, V1 over R1 plus V2 over R2. So the input is basically inverted. If they rearrange the formula, you will have something like this. RF over R1 V1 plus RF over R2 V2. If this is inverting type, you will have negative sign. The V out. All right. If you have more than two terms, two input voltage, you will have to add the third or the fourth term into this bracket. For example, if you have third V1, if you have third voltage, if you have third voltage, for example, here. Okay. So as V3. So this is R3. So my equation would be V out equal to negative. Okay. RF. Over R1, V1, then plus RF over R2. V2 plus RF over R3. I have to put V3 here somewhere. Okay. Sorry. V3. So this is basically your new term, for example. All right, so if you have more than three, you can basically just add up to the whole thing. All right. So for example here, example 2.18, develop an op-amp circuit that provide an output voltage related to the input voltage given by V out is equal to 3.4 V in plus 5. So we have plus here. If you look back, look back at the equation, we have V out, we have term V1, we have term V2 because it is two input. Here also they give you one term, two term. So this is amplifier with two input, summing amplifier. But from here you have to differentiate between which one is the resistor term, which one is the voltage term. Okay, in this case we have to do it yourself. For example, here given 3.4 V in plus 5, assuming the same relationship. So you can replace the term RF over R1 with G1 and RF over R2 with G2. And finally, here, okay, let's assume that G1 is equal to RF over R1 or to 3.4. So we take this 3.4 term as the R terms, all right? And G2, RF over R2 equal to 1. In this case, we are not seeing any R term, and we assume the 5 is the V in the voltage term. So in this case, RF over R2, we assume it is equal to 1. Okay, so V1, V in, V2 is equal to 5. So you have to put this assumption. Then you can basically use the whole thing to get the gain. And you can find RF R1, and you can find RF R2 basically from here. Okay. This is given to you 3.4 gain. Okay, so to get 3.4, you just assume RF and you assume R1 in this case. You use the assume information to get R2, and now basically you have a complete circuit of R1, R2, and RF. All right, so because this is inverting type, so your input is basically negative. So you need to do some inverting again. So this is how we basically invert the output of the first stage amplifier. We connect the output straight to the second stage amplifier with G equal to 1. Also inverting type. So G equal to 1, meaning that you have to have the RF and RIN, the value is more or less the same. All right. So this is how you solve the problem. Okay, the next type of circuit we can build using the same op-amp is differential amplifiers. Just now we are looking at summing amplifiers where we can add two input values to get one output value. Okay, I forgot to mention, for example, input we have V1 equal to 10, V2 equal to 10 volts, V1 equal to 10 volts. The V out we will normally get what they call that 20 volts, for example, depending on the whole circuit that you are putting in. But the V out straight away taking the what they call that direct input from V1, direct value from V1. And direct value from V2, right, depending on the gain factor that you set to RF and R1. Okay, so the next one is basically the differential amplifier. So in this case, we work with the subtraction symbol. For the summation, we work with the addition, but for this case, we work with the negative sign here, minus sign. So we are, subtracting one voltage from another. For example, here we want to this circuit. We still have RF. We have one voltage connected to the negative pin and the RF. Another voltage connected to the positive side. We have one resistor at the input, and one resistor to the ground. All right, and the whole circuit basically can be represented by this equation. where the V out is equal to RF over R1. This is the gain factor, RF over R1. So we set R2 equal to R1 and R2 equal to RF, right, where the V out is equal to the gain terms, and then you take the first voltage minus the second voltage, all right? If RF equal to divide by R1 equal to 1, so you can straight away take the input voltage minus the second input voltage as the V out. For example, if V1 here is 10 volts, V2 is 5 volts, so I can straight away take V out as 10 minus 5, so I have 5 volts at the end, provided RF over R1 is equal to 1. All right, this is how we use what they call that differential amplifiers. All right, this circuit is basically, you know, how normally we use differential amplifiers. We normally have voltage follower the input. This is some kind of impedance matching again. So for each leg we have one voltage follower. For another leg we have voltage follower. So basically our V out is going to take that formula. Okay. Example 2.20, a sensor output range 20 to 250 millivolt as a variable varies over its range, develops in the conditioning so that that this becomes 0 to 5. The circuit must have very, very high input impedance. So we have output range of a sensor is 20 to 250. Okay. Then you want to connect this sensor to a signal conditioning circuit so that this 20 to 250 millivolt become 0 to 5 volts. So this is some kind of range adjustment. So here we first solve the linear what they call that relationship between these two values. 20 millivolts will becoming 0. 250 millivolts will becoming 5 volts. All right, so we write the first equation as the what they call that linear equation, V out M V in plus V naught. Okay, so when V in is 20 millivolts, V out is 0. When V in is 250 millivolts, V out is 5. So you do the substitution, we basically get the final formula, get the value of M and V naught, and finally you will have the relationship between input and output of the circuit is this one. All right, so if you want to find the V out again, 21.0.4 to 3, so you can basically 21.71. We write again the linear relationship between V in and V out into a suitable form, right? We put everything all again. And then we compare with the formula for differential amplifier, you will get the gain factor. You have to go back to the differential amplifier, what they call that equation, which is this one. Okay. And you get the V2, and from here once we have both value, you can basically complete the circuit based on the assumed what they call that parameters. All right, you have to go back to the formula of differential amplifier, because the whole idea of this question is to develop signal conditioning circuit. So you have to redraw the circuit and find the value for the resistors in the circuit, okay, using the formula. All right, so also the same, you have to connect this type of amplifier, this type of differential amplifier, into a voltage follower circuit, okay. And then in some cases, in some cases, we want to convert the voltage output of any system or any sensor into a current input so that the next device can basically read current, okay, and not voltage. If in some situation there is a need to do conversion between voltage to current, and in some cases you need to do conversion between current to voltage depending on the environment that you are working with. All right. So this is basically the standard or the very common and the very typical form of voltage to current circuit with its formula, of course. You have I, the output current here, taking these values of in the function of V in, because you want to convert this voltage into this current. Okay, so this is the relationship that works with the circuit. All right, this is another form of voltage to current converter using op amp. All right, basically you can find many kind of many form of circuit on the internet. If you Google, for example, voltage to current circuit using op amp, you will see many of the versions. Okay, of course, normally when we want to use this, we normally go for the datasheet. We have to look at the chips and how we're going to use this as a voltage to current conversion. And we normally will follow the recommendation or the schematic by the datasheet, and they will come together with this formula so you can use it. So another form of conversion circuit is the current to voltage converter. Just now we have voltage to current. Now we have current to voltage. This is the circuit, and VR is equal to I multiplied by the R. So I is the input current, I is the feedback resistor, and straight away we get a VR from here. Okay, the next form of circuit which we are going to look at is the voltage comparator. Okay. The voltage comparator basically compares two voltage in the inputs, in the input terminal. Depending on which voltage is larger, the output will be either 0 or 1. For example, the op-amp that basically do this job is LM34. Okay, so we have two voltage here, VA and VB, regardless of the value. If VA is bigger than VB, for example, this is 7 volt, this is 5 volt. So VA is exactly bigger than or larger than VB, the output will be 1. One here takes the high logic in the digital world, in the analog world. One will be taking the voltage that is applied to the op amp. If this op amp is taking 5 volt supply, the logic one here will be giving out 5 volts. All right. So if VB here is bigger than VA, or VA is smaller, then we will have zero logic or zero volt at the output. So you will get either 0 or 1 or 5 volt or 0 volt at the output, depending on which one is bigger and which one is smaller. So this is the comparator circuit. This is basically a long example. Okay. Let me Yeah, right. We continue. If you look at this example, the process control system specifies that temperature should never exceed 160 degrees Celsius if the pressure also exceeds 10 kilopascal. The design and alarm system to detect this condition using temperature and pressure transducer with transfer function of 2.2 millivolts per 1 degree Celsius and 0.2 volt per 1 kilopascal respectively. So you are basically to design an alarm system that depends on two parameters, which is the temperature and the pressure. And in the case where the input temperature is bigger than 160 degrees Celsius, okay. And also the pressure should never exceed 10 kilopascal. Okay, so you have two cases here. Okay, the temperature should never exceed if the pressure also exceeds, meaning that this is some kind of AND gate. If both parameters exceed both values, so then you can sound the alarm basically. All right. So first, so this is more or less you should be able to notice that this is going to the case of voltage of the utilization of a comparator, because you have things that you want to check. You have values that you want to check. You want to check the input values, whether it is exceeding 160 degrees Celsius or whether the pressure is exceeding 10 kilopascal. And you have a transfer function here in which you can do the comparison. In the analog circuitry, you know, you cannot simply compare temperature to temperature, because in the instrumentation system, you don't have information in terms of temperature in the circuit. All you have is either impedance, voltage, or current. So whatever you have here, you have to convert back into the voltage. That's why you are given the transfer function which have the value of voltage on both sides. You have the temperature side and the pressure side. So you can use these two values, 160 degrees Celsius and 10 kilopascal, as the threshold value, but you have to convert first to the voltage, because comparator works from voltage to voltage, and comparator doesn't work for other units like degrees Celsius or kilopascal. All right. So first, you have to do is you have to convert the limit, temperature limit, using the limit given 160 degrees Celsius with the system transfer function. So you have voltage limit is 0.352. The same for the pressure. So you have 2 volts. So now you have voltage to compare with. All right, and you can always rearrange your circuit to something like this. You have T in, this is your voltage T limit, 0.352 represent 160 degrees Celsius, and voltage 2.0 volts represent 10 kilopascal. So this is your input, this is your temperature input, this is your temperature pressure input, and then the transfer function. So you are basically doing this. If this one is bigger, you have to connect to the positive side, meaning that if this one goes bigger, you have the output becoming 1. If this one smaller than the voltage here, 0.2, the output will become 0. So you have to draw this thing, you have to do for both, and basically you can redraw again and connect to the system with the AND gate, because you have to see here, since the alarm will not trigger if both temperature and pressure exceed, VT and VT limit respectively, AND gate can be used to ensure that the requirement is met, because the question say both must be going beyond limit, then only you can trigger the alarm. If only one triggered, this one is not triggered, this one will not be triggered. For this particular case, it is much more easier for you to describe the input and output in terms of truth table. So in this case, both input must be triggered, then the alarm will be triggered. All right, so the next circuit we are looking at is specifically integrator. This is the circuit, and those are the formula. For the circuit, integrator and differentiator, you know, has never been very much asked in the exam. So good to know the circuit, good to know that such circuit basically existed for integrator and differentiator. Okay, so please take note on the schematic and the formula that basically All right, I'm gonna leave you guys with this example and basically do it yourself. Okay, it's all more or less the same. Okay, so basically that's the end of lecture B. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Thank you very much.